Well, hi everybody, thanks so much for coming. I'm really happy to share with you these collage works. They're kind of new to me and also new to showing. And they kind of come out of a practice of drawing. So I think first of all, I'll just share a little bit about the origin story of how they came to be, explain a little bit kind of technically how they come together, and talk a little bit about the kind of imagery and the content that's within the collages. So first of all, how they kind of came to be, this kind of work comes out of a drawing practice, and so as a drawer, I also was always along the way amassing a lot of source imagery that I was interested in, either things that ended up in the drawings themselves as sources, or just things that I was interested in visually that inspired me in some way or somehow felt like they kind of connected to my visual language and I wanted to kind of think about further. So I just had a lot of stuff around. And at some point along the way, after all of these archived images and books had kind of lived with me for a while, I became a little bit less precious about the actual the actual matter themselves. And I also, at some point, you know, as all of us creative people experience, sometimes I felt like I was a little bit in a rut with the work I was making. I wanted to kind of switch things up a little bit. And so I started just digging into my archive and starting to just cut things up. And so that's where the collages kind of came to be, and is kind of thinking about new ways of constructing a composition, kind of how that changes the outcome in terms of, you know, how the image kind of comes together. And so the pieces of these collages come from a variety of different sources, largely nature books, kind of nature magazines, science textbooks. I have an interest in kind of the written word and language and kind of poetry, but feel very kind of self-conscious about my own writing. And so it's been interesting with the collage practice to actually kind of find little bits of text that can play with the imagery as well. So there's some kind of text that kind of talks to the content of the visual work as well within these pieces. Also, there's a lot of kind of patterns that you'll find in the collages, and in many cases, those patterns come from security envelopes. I've also had an ongoing security envelope collection that I thought was entirely kind of separate from my art making, but I felt like there was an interesting kind of language there of kind of a pattern filling in a certain area of the composition, kind of both kind of flattening out the composition in some places or kind of obscuring it or kind of like changing spatially how the image reads. And so that's where, you know, there's kind of a sense of landscape in these works, but then that landscape also can get kind of flattened or kind of glitch with these other elements that are collaged together. And that's where, with the collage work, what has interested me, I think, is how the images, kind of at first glance, look like they kind of resolve spatially, like they look kind of logical as landscape. And it's only kind of on closer looking that you realize that things kind of like are flipping or glitching, or you get kind of pushed out of the image by kind of like a flat region. And so I think it's kind of interesting to explore an image that like looks like it makes sense at first glance and then falls apart with longer looking, and kind of gets more complicated and kind of trickier. And so within the images, one of the things that I think about is having the images kind of span between, you know, elements that are very recognizable, kind of photographic and specific, and then elements that are kind of flatter or more graphic or more kind of diagrammatic. So kind of like playing between that kind of representation and abstraction. And so in terms of technically, I mean, these are all the actual material adhered to the paper. In most cases, the the elements of the collage are kind of stacked vertically in this kind of like geologic kind of stacking, or kind of that sense of kind of archiving or layering. So there's something kind of in the language of the kind of stacking that's going on in these as well. There are some elements of drawing kind of like that are hidden and kind of embedded in some of these as well. So there's still kind of a sense of the mark, either in terms of my actual hand or the kind of patterns that are found elsewhere. And it doesn't necessarily matter if those are kind of legible as, you know, actual handmade marks or kind of a found pattern. It's all just kind of like part of the vocabulary kind of visually that I'm playing with. You know, I had first kind of drifted into this collage from drawing. And so I was trying to think about the ways that those two practices could kind of interact, just exploring, you know, what that would do compositionally. In some cases, it was because some of the ephemera that I had around were kind of old failed drawings that sometimes I would like take a little piece out of and use as a collage material. And so kind of like repurposing some things that didn't actually end up on the wall previously. And then sometimes using drawing as kind of a layered element to add, say, like a grid or some sort of like patterned mark making on top of a collage material to kind of add another layer of information. So those are kind of the different kind of ideas behind adding the mark making within the work. So these are all the original pieces of paper. They're under the UV glass, so that should kind of protect the materials, you know, somewhat. And actually, you know, a lot of the papers, one of the things that I like about the subtlety of the collage is the various whites, like the bright white and the yellower white and the even yellower white, against the sort of like creamy white of the paper that they're mounted on. And so the whites kind of playing on each other is one of the things I'm interested in. And so some of those things are because the materials themselves are old, and sometimes it's because they've been sitting around in my studio kind of catching light for a while. So part of that aging is kind of part of, you know, part of the color that I'm playing with. Yeah. Thank you all so much for coming. I really appreciate it.